Hello everyone, I'm Michael Rubano, lead engineer at Chicago Audio Collective, and we're showing the Harmony 200 amplifier that came in for restoration. And it's a pretty straightforward design. It uses true point-to-point wiring, meaning the components are wired from tube socket to tube socket, or other components are wired in. There are no tag boards, no eyelet boards, nothing like that. So that's what's referred to as true point-to-point wiring. And in the case of this amplifier, like so many others, it had all of its original capacitors, and they were of a paper dielectric type, which were completely no longer viable. Replaced them with modern replacements throughout, just as they did with insulators and point-to-point wiring. We also addressed the power supply. The original capacitor was mounted through a hole in the chassis and sat vertically. Capacitors like that are a little difficult to get, so what I was able to do is install a tag board and wire them in directly with insulated wiring, and they're over here. There's also another power supply capacitor that's located here. And its original had failed, and not only that, but its insides had leaked out onto the chassis and left a stain on the inside. So all of that has been cleared away and new components have been installed. In addition to that, I tested all the resistors, and they all were within spec, including the cathode bypass resistor, so we were able to retain that. It's a very high quality type that's actually bolted to the chassis, and it still functions, so we left that in place. We also did serious cleaning of the controls, replaced a couple of broken jacks, and in addition to that, this amplifier has a fourth jack. This jack here is not an original. It was installed by its owner at some point, and it's worked into the circuit. It happened to have been broken, so I replaced it with a new one. Also, it has a new output section and rectifier tube, or set of tubes. The input tubes were new. They had been replaced at some point, so we were able to retain those. And I also installed a plug where the original capacitor was for safety. When I received this amplifier, I noticed that the power transformer was attached in a way that didn't seem right. It was sort of crooked. And upon further inspection, I realized that two of its fasteners were not there, and most importantly, it's not the original transformer. So I tested it to make sure that it was the appropriate type for this amplifier and that it was functioning. Then I removed it and reinstalled it. I was able to reuse some of the hardware and use new hardware, so it's mounted firmly and squarely on the chassis and it's not going to come loose. Along with that, the way the amplifier was wired, the cable that goes between the chassis and the speaker passes through the cabinet in such a way that traps it inside. So I installed this multi-way connector so that the amplifier or the speaker could be removed without cutting and splicing the wires. And I was able to figure out in the process of preparing it, this is not the original speaker. It's bigger than the original and the is mounted in new holes that are drilled through the cabinet. But it does sound great, and you'll see that very shortly. The last thing we did, as we did with almost all the amplifiers of this age, I replaced the original power cord, which was not grounded, with a new modern grounded cord and a new strain relief. So should this thing tip over backwards or something like that, we're not going to have any problems. So once again, this amplifier is back to its original shape. It's safe and it sounds great, and it's going to work for many years to come.
This Harmony amp was made in Chicago in 1947, so just after the war ended. Again, rock and roll hadn't come to fruition yet. It was really, a number of years before that all came along. So these amps were basically designed to be played with big jazz body guitars. Big band was ending, although nobody knew it at the time, and jazz and rock and roll was coming into fruition. This is the kind of amp that you really love to have. It's not loud, but the tone that comes out of it is just velvety smooth, and this would be the kind of thing you'd see sitting in a corner at Chess Records in Chicago sounding like this.
Thank you.
And that's all you need out of a great amp.